Hey y'all, DPD here. Alright, so the developer of this little indie game actually contacted me, asking me to do a video of it. He was like, talk about it, do a video of it, just be honest. So, here I am. So this is Woof Blaster. You are a dogman who wants to be king of the dog planet. And in doing so, you have to kill waves and levels of enemies, each one progressively harder. Your typical shmup deal. Shoot enemies, get credits, money, whatever, get power-ups, kill more enemies. You know, your basic deal. So, let me get into the game mechanics a little bit. So first, what you're seeing here is rage mode. You can see you have a rage bar right at the top there, which will slowly fill up over time. You also have your power bar, which coincides with those two icons. Those are your powers. You have a left power and right power. My left power is a trident, which shoots tridents everywhere, which you saw earlier, and you'll see again later in the video. And the right power is boot. I've never used it. Now, after each level, you go and buy stuff from the shop. Your money is those green things, pounds. You use it to buy power-ups, as I just said. So, that's basically the mechanics. Shoot things, buy power-ups. Shoot more things, buy more power-ups. So let me preface before I get into the nitty gritty is I really like this game. So keep that in mind with everything I'm going to say. I actually really did enjoy this game. It's a lot of fun. It's just not very challenging. I'm sorry. It's way, way too easy of a game. This video is like 11 minutes. That's the entire game. I beat the entire game in 11 minutes. It's very short, very easy. Too easy. You're not going to get a lot out of this game. Not in this format. Now, let me preface. Let me say here, this is a beta. The game is not officially out yet. But that being said, it's just way too easy and way too short. You should not be able to beat any decent game in 11 minutes. Now, I brought this up to the developer, and he did say he's going to work on increasing the difficulty, but still, you know, unless he really ramps it up, it's just too easy. I've beaten bosses simply with rage mode. As you see, I use rage mode on every boss, and pretty much nearly kills them. And as I said, at times I have killed them simply with rage mode. I've killed this boss before many times with simply rage mode. They were just simply too easy. That is probably my biggest pet peeve with the game. That's my biggest complaint about this game. It is far, far too easy of a game. It is also far, far too short. You're going to get those 6 slices of pizza in no time. Like when I was originally recording this, like I'll just do a couple levels. I was like, I'm gonna do it pretty quickly. I might as well see how long it is. And much to my chagrin, 10 minutes. I beat this game about 3 times in 40 minutes. And that's me taking my time experimenting with different weapons, different power-ups. Speaking of weapons and power-ups, I also have to say the power bar charges. Look at that. The power bar charges way, way too fast. You pretty much can just spam those powers. That's not good. So that all said, I will say, I did enjoy the game, even though it was way too easy. I do like the soul it's got. It's got a lot of soul, a lot of heart in it. And he definitely took time drawing all these characters. These are not just some generic sprites. These are all you can tell, hand-drawn graphics, which I kudos to the developer. Speaking of the developer, this is apparently his first game from what I can tell. I think he's also a younger developer, just from what I've, the impression I've gotten through the emails and through this game. So, all criticism aside, when this is released on Steam, especially if it fixes the difficulty and it's cheap enough, please, please buy this game. I get no personal benefit from it. It's not like he's paying me money. But I want to, I just feel like we really need to spend our money more on indie games and indie developers than some big monolithic corporation like EA or Ubisoft or Warner Brothers. Any developers, if it's an indie developer that brought one of the most beloved games of all time, Minecraft, is it? It's these indie developers that treat us well. These small developers that treat us well. We're like, thank you for playing my game. I want to tell you how much that means to me. Where's Warner Brothers? I know I'm getting off into a rant here, but I'm a ranty sort of fucker. So fucking deal with it. When you got companies like Warner fucking Brothers putting out shit like the Batman PC game, that was atrocious. And get companies like EA putting atrocious DRM in games. And now with Windows 10, a lot of those games won't fucking work because of that stupid goddamn DRM. And then they want you to be locked in to DRM-riddled storefronts. And sorry, Steam is one of them. And yes, this game is on Steam also, but it's just easier. It's a very simple platform for getting these sorts of games out. But still, give your hard-earned money to indie developers first. If this game's like a couple bucks, a couple pounds, get it. It is fun, especially if it fixes the difficulty. If he wraps up with that difficulty, you're gonna have probably get another good 20, 30, 40 hours out of this game for a small little indie game. That's not too bad. And also, hopefully, he'll work on length and can make it even longer. I just want to show this guy that, despite all the things he did wrong with this game, he can learn, he can do, don't get discouraged, and make more indie games. Of course, as you make as gather, I have a deep fondness for indie games and indie developers. I try to focus more on their games and AAA games on my channel. That's just me. So let's get back to this game. I haven't ranted long enough, so fuck the story. The story is silly. The story is stupid. There's nothing to it. You're trying to become king of Dogland by collecting pizza slices. That makes no sense. But I'm not going to go off on that. It's a story. I mean, take out this stupid little cutscene with the dog father yapping away. And, well, you just really don't need it. You don't need any of the story. Just have him go around killing baddies. Just have the funniness of it being a dog man. Yeah. No, uniqueness. I can't think of the term. You don't need the story. The story's stupid, ridiculous. But overall, there's definitely a gem hidden in this game. There's definitely something to this game. If he just busts his ass and gets it harder, gets it longer, then it can really be, I think, a good little indie gem that you really should check out. If it's cheap enough, just buy it. If it's a couple of bucks, a couple of pounds, buy it. Show him some love. Show him that we want to support indies. It is fun. It is very enjoyable just blowing shit up. Just shooting enemy after enemy after enemy. So, really, that's about it for my commentary for this video. The video is about over. Yes, that's a cat that wants to take the pizza and become king of the dogs. Cats rule, dogs drool, I guess. But anyway, this is DVD signing out. check out the game Steam page link in the description, like, subscribe, blah, 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 and have a good one.